to the NAIA Hall of Fame. The Hall of Fame is the highest honor bestowed upon our NAIA membership, and we're very proud of this Hall of Fame class. Please turn your attention to the video screens as we begin this portion of our program.
Maybe someday I can get on that list. maybe if I hang in there and keep doing well, we can get on that list. And like I said, thank you.
Preparing to start this journey. You know what it is, guys. Like,
first game, you're nervous, extremely nervous. You want everything to be perfect. You want the team to be great. You want everything to be just right. 20 minutes before the game, somebody ran up to me and said, "Coach, what are we going to do about the national anthem?" I said, "Oh my gosh, I forgot the national anthem." I ran out to the parking lot, got in my car, 20 minutes before the game, drove to downtown Columbia, ran into this wonderful little record store called Streetside Records, ran into the store and was met by a clerk. And let me describe the clerk. He had spiked hair everywhere. He had piercings everywhere, was dressed totally in leather and chains. Just picture the Birdman. He said, "How can I help you?" And I said, "I'm really in a hurry. I need a tape of the national anthem." And he went to the back. And you know what it's like when you're really, really in a hurry. Seconds are hours. And I didn't think he'd ever return. He came back and he said, "Well, I couldn't find the national anthem with the Star Spangled Banner work." I said, "It will tonight." I guess after that episode, Columbia College decided I needed a ton of administrative help. And many of you are here today, and I'd like to acknowledge you. Dr. Bruder, our president, Webb Bixby, our honorary coach and board member, board trustee member, and great friend. Faculty athletic representatives, Liz Metcher and Dr. Polly. Associate athletic director, Cindy Potty, who you saw in the film, put my nomination. Assistant AD Drew Brazella, coordinator of athletic services, Kim Flegel, great staff friends, Jane Long and Phil Sprint, many former assistant coaches in our current staff as well, current staff members Sean Dooley, Steve Burke, Michael Fields, Mark Mueller, Sean Erickson, Greg Luxon, Jim Finley, and great personal friends, Gene Pepe, who has sat beside me on the bench for 24 years. Gene Wolofsky is here as well, another great friend. Our Cougar Club members, and I do have to mention my longtime friend and coaching legend and mentor, Gary Fogel, who's no longer with us. Today, my name has been mentioned, but truly today honors Columbia College and each and every one of you. And great things have been happening in Columbia for 25 years. Coaches and referees are always interesting. I guess that's a very revolution. Once the Champions Character Program started, it was about the same time that we went to three referees. And I was at the Champions Character presentation, the presenter was looking at me and telling me how important it was to develop a relationship with the officials. You know, when you had three referees, every time somebody shoots a free throw on you're in the court, one of them standing right in front of you. So I thought, okay, in a game here in Kansas City, somebody's name you might recognize. I put this newfound relationship building with the referees to work. So the first free throw went all right, and I've got Pee Wee Summers standing in front of me. And I said, "Hey, Pee Wee, you're looking great. I think you're awesome. I love the outfit you wore to the game today." I said, "You know, Pee Wee, I think you're the best official I've ever had, and that guy standing under the basket is really struggling. You need to help him out." So that was my start. I thought it was all pretty good. The next free throw down on our end of the floor, I had Bill Stompoli standing in front of me. I said, "Hey, Bill, how are you?" He said, "You're looking great. How are those knees doing? You're moving pretty good tonight." I said, "Phil, I think you're doing an awesome job. You're the best official we've ever had." I said, "That guy in the basket is horrible." And I said, "You have got to help him out." About third free throw down on our end, Larry Lady standing in front of me. And young Larry Lady, I see he beats me to the punch. He says, "Bob, I've been standing under that basket for the last two free throws, and I want to know what you told those guys." I said, "Larry, I told him you'd be glad to help him out at halftime." We got hammered. From John Clogney to Jerry Pollard to J.D. Collins to Justin Ingles to Pee Wee Summers to Phil Stompoli and yes, Larry Lady, we have had great relationships. Coaches and players don't always think alike.
Our first year at Columbia, Columbia College had never had a winning season. And I told the guys, if we had a winning season, we were going to cut down some nets and that down. And the day was coming. We knew we were guaranteed a winning season. And I was so excited. And as the game wore down, it's like a championship game. And when we knew we were going to win, I took off running across that court like Jim Galvano, just won the national championship. Looking for scissors to cut down the nets. Out of the corner of my eye, I saw our best player running down the hallway, out the door, out of the gym, like Jim Galvano. And it really bothered me. Only later did I find out that his Columbia girlfriend was behind the bench during the game, and that his out-of-state Florida girlfriend had shown up as a surprise and was sitting right next to his Columbia. He was not interested in cutting down nets. I hope each of you, writers out there this week, are interested in cutting down nets. Tonight, my name has been mentioned, but truly tonight honors the team that we have here now and all the teams that preceded you. Tonight is your honor. Coaching is a family business, as Bret said. When Bret was six, doing all the things he talked about. He was working our bench, and we had after the Harper home lost. And Mom was putting him to bed and tucking him in. And Bret looked up at his mother and said, Mom, I don't think Dad used his personnel to work very well tonight. And Mom, being a great mom, said, you know what, Bret? I think you're right. I totally agree. But let's just keep that between us. I do have family here. My wife, Miss Faye, who also serves as the Dean of Student Services there at Columbia College. Our beautiful daughter, Jennifer, and her husband, Matt, and brother, Ed. Tonight, my name has been mentioned, but tonight truly honors the sacrifices you all have made to help my dream come true. I truly do thank each and every one of you. This is one moment in time that I will cherish for our life.